All right, here we are again. Another Venture Soul Creates. I'm Rihanna, if you haven't been following me already. I'm just kind of working on anything and everything I can get my hands on craft-wise. So today, I'm going to show you how to make one of these little trees. I saw a tutorial on how to do this. I've seen it all over the internet, and I wanted to make one, but in the tutorials I've seen, it's a rustic tree, and I'm not a very rustic person. I'm more of an eclectic person. So, of course, when I sat down to do it, I just grabbed whatever I had at hand, and it happened to be some very colorful sock yarn, which is very me, and some brightly colored little beads here. Not sure where this is landing on camera, so yeah, so this is the one that I made. I wanted to kind of just do a little tutorial on it to show you that you can use, you know, whatever size yarn you have at hand or whatever kind of beads you have on hand. You don't need to go out and buy you know, tree colored yarn and the wooden beads and what, like, twine and stuff. You can do this with whatever you have. Like, I literally just grabbed from my pile that is sitting next to me. So without further ado, let's get into it. So I used sock yarn again because that was literally what was here next to me, and I have a lot of it. And I don't, it's not dedicated for anything. I'm not somebody who has a lot of, like, extra yarn laying around. I have a lot of yarn, but generally it's intended for something other than my sock yarn here, which is kind of just for whatever. So I picked two colors that I thought look kind of nice together. Let's see. What do I want to use here? Oh, I think I like these two. Yeah, so I've got these, and then I've got these, like, kind of tealy beads. I don't know if I want to use these with them, so I'm gonna dig around a little bit and see what else I have. Again, what's right on hand, right kind of next to me here. What do I have that will work? Those are kind of cool. I'm gonna have to edit this video a bit. So, I mean, I literally, this is just me going over to a box of beads I have and just grabbing some stuff out of it that I thought might look cute. With the kinds of colors that I'm using. Okay, they're just going everywhere. That's okay. So, we're going to start out with our chain. So again, I'm using some very, like, very thin fingering weight yarn here. I say very thin because it's kind of closer to lace weight. And I'm using a 3.75 millimeter hook, and I have these doubled up because I just didn't have anything thicker than that on hand, and I didn't want them to be tiny. So I thought these colors looked nice together, so this is what I'm going to use. Alright, so we're going to start out by chaining 60. You don't have to chain 60, it just gives a nice length if you want to make something that is this size. which is roughly 2.5 inches wide at the base and roughly 3 inches tall. 60 chains will do that for you in either a double-stranded lightweight sock yarn like this, or you could also achieve the same thing with like a thicker DK or a medium to thicker DK would probably give you around the same size. Okay, so anyways, we're gonna chain 60. Again, it doesn't really matter how many you chain. 60 is just gonna give you this size for something. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. My camera just made a noise. Okay, nothing happened. Might have just bumped my tripod. Alright, I was on 25. 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34. Making sure I'm in the right space here. Yeah. Thirty-five, thirty-six, thirty-seven, thirty-eight, thirty-nine, forty, forty-one, forty-two, forty-three, forty-four, forty-five, forty-six, forty-seven, forty-eight, forty-nine, fifty, fifty-one, fifty-two, fifty-three, fifty-four, fifty-five, fifty-six, fifty-seven, fifty-eight, fifty-nine, and sixty. And then however many chains you chain, you're going to want to add two. So 1, 2. And that's because we're going to skip these first two chains when we start working back down our chain. All right. And then so we're going to skip these two chains, 1, 2. And we're going to work into the third chain a half double crochet. Right, and then you're going to work a half double crochet into every chain all the way down your chains, all the way down your strand here. Okay. Oops. And that's the biggest issue with using a double strand of yarn like this is sometimes you're going to miss a strand. But you know what? That's okay. We're not trying to be perfect here. This is just a cute little Christmas decoration. This does not need to be perfect, and that's part of why I am making this video. Because so many of us are perfectionists. We want to do everything perfect every single time, and things just don't need to be that way. I think that the main thing with any kind of craft is that you should be having fun. So, you know, don't stress yourself out. Something isn't going exactly according to plan. As long as it doesn't look awful, just run with it. Like, I'm dropping strands here on some of these. I'm splitting my yarn. But it's just a Christmas decoration. Nobody's gonna wear this. It doesn't need to hold up to being washed. No one's gonna notice at the end of the day. It is just a cute, fun project to share with my family and with all of you. So anyways, I'm going to kind of speed through the rest of this. All right, so there are all of our half doubles. Now I'm gonna cut my yarn. I'm gonna leave my tails free for now because I'm gonna use them at the end to kind of even some things out. Okay, so now we're gonna take this and we're gonna kind of coil it up. So I'm gonna go like this, and then back like this, and then back like this. Basically like a little snake here. And that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 little coils here. So that's what we're, that's what we want. I'm gonna use my, use my yarn needle here to just kind of poke through it and hold it while I get everything else set up. So now let's go in for our beads. I think I'm gonna use these little crocheted beads. Let's see, I want 4 of them. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna have 4 of them. And then actually I'm gonna take my yarn needle out of here. I'm gonna see if it fits through these beads, because the last ones I used, my yarn needle didn't fit through. It does, that's fantastic. Okay, so I don't need this and the thread, which is nice, because I didn't really enjoy that on the last one. It was just, it didn't fit, so I had to use it for the beads on this one, because the hole was too small for my yarn needle, tapestry needle. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the bead at the top here, and we're gonna put it through roughly the middle. It doesn't have to be perfect. And then we're gonna go through 2 of these little nubbins, and then add another bead, and then go through 2 more, again, roughly in the middle. Okay, and then we're gonna add another bead. Hopefully this is all in frame here. I'm not always the best at keeping things in frame. Okay, through the middle again. And then add our last bead. Do I have another one? No, not of those. Okay. I was thinking it would be cute to put one like at the bottom, like it was a trunk or something, but I don't have another one, so I'm not gonna worry about it. Okay. So we've got that. Got our yarn tails out of the way here. Okay, and then so we're gonna come back up through the bottom and through each of the beads again. I might have to kind of stop at 2 and pull the needle through. I'm gonna leave a little loop at the bottom so I can tie a bow on it. I didn't do that on the last one, but I think that's gonna be cute. So I'm gonna do it on this one. Up and through and back up through our last bead. I'll hold that little loop at the bottom that I made so I don't pull it out. And I'm just gonna tighten this. And see, so here's roughly our tree. I'm gonna take my yarn needle off and I'm going to cut my yarn here. I'm gonna tie it in a little bow at the top. Actually, no, what am I doing? Okay, I'm gonna make a loop here. So I'm just gonna knot this, and this will be like what I will hang this from, like the Christmas tree from. Then I'm gonna cut this off, and I'm gonna use one of these pieces to tie a little bow here. Stay back. This isn't really quite long enough for a bow, so I'm just gonna leave it like that. I think that's cute. And then I'm gonna take this one, and you know, I don't know what I was planning on doing with this one. I don't really have a plan. I'm just gonna leave it. Okay, So then I wanted to do a little extra something on this one that I didn't do on the other one. In my bead box, I found these little dangly bits. Oh, I had another one of these little blue ones. I might have dropped it. I dropped quite a few things, so I might have dropped it. Find it, so I'm not worried about it. But so I'm gonna take my little yarn end here, and this is just a little like, it's a little like saint charm. I have a lot of these, and I'm gonna just actually first let me stay organized here. So the reason I left these tails on is so that I can weave the ends in on this. So it kind of like pulls this end part up, because I was having an issue with the first one that I did where ends were just kind of flapping down and I didn't really like it. So I'm just gonna weave these back and forth a couple of times. Make sure that I come out in a bottom section here so that you can see bottom and like back section so you can't really see my weaving in. Oh, that's my little nubbins there. Okay. Use that loop there to tighten this all up. Okay, so that one's woven in. Cut those tails. And then do my other set of tails. Hopefully I'm in frame here. I keep forgetting that I need to be. Something I need to get a lot better at. I can't see the back of my camera when I'm using my big camera for this. It's off to the side. So it's really hard for me to tell if I'm actually in frame. I'm trying. Just rest assured that I'm trying. Okay. Okay, tighten that up. And then just weave these through. Oops. Come on, Rihanna. It's not even like I'm nervous on a video or something. I'm just actually this clumsy and fumbly in real life. There's no accounting for it. It's just who I am. it's a vibe. It's my vibe. Okay, so I'm not gonna worry about these being super, super secure. Okay. So I'm gonna cut those ones a little shorter. Don't really want to see them. Okay, so here's our tree. It's got its loop to be able to hang it. And now I'm gonna secure these little things like they're little ornaments. So I'm gonna put that one there. I'm gonna put this one here. And then I think I'm gonna hang this guy from the little nubbins at the bottom here. Because I just think that's really cute. I'm gonna give this to my mom. I think she'll really appreciate this. This is something that came from my grandma, and I think that that will make her smile to put this on her tree. Okay, so I'm gonna get this little tiny bit here on my yarn. Wait, is it gonna fit through? Oh, my yarn needle's not gonna fit through that. Okay, well, that's not a problem. So what we're gonna do is first, I'm gonna attempt to feed the yarn through the bead here. Or we might just be stitching this on. Okay, so that's why I have actual thread here and a tiny little sewing needle, because this was a problem with my last one. Okay. So I'm gonna just thread that on, and then I'm gonna take my two ends here and I'm gonna put them together. And I'm gonna tie it. I'm gonna try to get it as close to the base of the top of the bead here as possible. But it doesn't matter if it's not exact, because it's supposed to be like an ornament, so it's not like it needs to be perfect. Okay. I get my little ends here and attempt to get them through this tiny, tiny needle, which was the biggest one I could find at the moment and is still very, very small. Aha. Got it. Okay. So I wanted it up here. So I'm just gonna go in here. I'm not trying to be very precise about it. Oops. Yeah, I'm just gonna sew that on here, and I'm just gonna do, I'm not trying to be super perfect about this. I'm just stitching it on kind of like haphazardly so that it stays. It's not about perfection here. That's not the goal. Perfection is not the goal, which is a good exercise for some of us, because I can be a bit of a perfectionist myself, but part of the reason that I like to do these videos is because it reminds me, too, that things don't need to be perfect. We just need to enjoy ourselves. And that's what's most important. So, you know, being happy is a lot more important than something being perfect. And if what makes you happy is something being perfect, well, that... Okay, so my camera battery died. I didn't have another one charged, so I had to go and charge it for a few minutes before I could start again. But basically, I just stitched this guy on here so it just kind of hangs all cute. And I'm going to get a little more thread. And just do the same thing over again. Try to remember to stay in the frame. And that's kind of important for making videos. Okay. And once again, attempt to get my thread through this tiny, tiny, tiny little needle. Oh, come on. Got one piece in there, and I got both pieces in there. Yay! Okay, and this one I wanted to put right here. Oops, again. Okay. beads out of here, getting them away. There we go, and then I'm just gonna do like I did before, and I'm just gonna stitch this on here. Again, not trying to be perfect, just trying to make it stay. My only goal here is to make it stay. To make it so, you could say. Ha ha ha, Star Trek joke. Bonus points if you're a Star Trek fan. Okay. Okay, so I got that tacked on. And then I'm going to take this little Saint Charm and I'm going to take one of my little yarn scraps here. Feed it through. And come up here to this. I don't really have a plan for this, but I think I'm just gonna thread this through and then, oh yeah, I'll do it like this. I'll just pull it tight. And then I'm actually gonna take this little bow thing I made off. It's just getting in the way. And I don't really like it. All right, and then I'm gonna pull this all tight. And you know what? I'm going to do this a little bit differently. I'm going to untie this. And untie this. This looks. This is really cute. This is really cute. Okay, so tie that and then tie this up here so it has a little loop to hang a hook from so it can go on a Christmas tree. And there you have it. This is one last little detail. So I was going to try to tie this into a bow. It's kind of a small piece of yarn, so I don't know how successful I'm going to be. As we have discussed, I'm not the most delicate of people, so I'm gonna try. Oh my goodness. Okay, just go through. Almost have it. Oh, not quite. Okay. You know what? I'm just going to leave it like that. I think that's cute. Okay, and there it is. So these are my little yarn Christmas trees. And yeah, I mean, you know, there's nothing wrong with the rustic ones that I keep seeing all over Facebook and everything and the groups that I'm in. But I just wanted to kind of show a different way to do them. Because, you know, we're not all the same. And I know, like, I tend to do things, like, a lot differently than other people do a lot of the time. And I like to share that with people so that you all know that if you have an idea and you want to try to make your idea. There's nothing wrong with that. You don't have to do things the same way that anybody else does. Here is this. Should I add another one? I feel like maybe I want to add this one. What do we think? No, I think that's going to make it too busy. And I probably have more of those, so I can make another one and add that. But yeah, so, I mean, again, everybody's different, and you should just do things the way that you want to do them and not worry about the way that other people do things. That's my point. If you have an idea, just try it. You know, don't worry about what other people are going to think. Just make yourself happy. That's really the point of life. And again, here are my little...